Huh. I don't know. I think we're on again.
Are we?
Yeah, I think we're on again, but I just don't know. I don't know why we're on sometimes and why we're not.
Not funny. Wow, it's funny. Huh? That's the best way, though, right?
Okay, so we're back. I have no clue what I'm doing here. I don't even know how I just... Oh my goodness, this is frustrating. Yeah, we're trying to figure out how to go full screen, guys. We don't really know how. What's the back camera?
Because you're on the iPad?
Just don't touch the computer.
So what, you guys can see us?
Yeah, we're back on.
Cool.
But I don't know why we're not full screen. So some people have said we're kind of hard to see. So I don't know what that means.
Okay.
Yeah. And plus there's a little bit of a delay.
Oh, there's Emma Gardner. Hi, Luke.
I don't know why.
Canyon Country, that's nearby.
Did you say Luke is online?
Yeah, I just saw him right there. Emma Gardner.
Hey, Luke, if you're online, what software do you use for streaming? Would you mind emailing Kim or texting her or just something? Tell Kim not to touch the iPad. Well, honestly, that was me.
Us old people can't figure this new tech out.
Oh, hey.
Hi, Pam from Acton.
Okay. You're good. Just a small picture, but
it's
not
a
big deal.
It's a replay. We're not live. Okay. Well.
Yeah, we are live, actually. There's just there's like a 10-second delay. But this is really cool, guys. We want to start doing this, a little more often and do a little Q&A with you all and get to know you guys a little bit more through this. But we're trying to work out the kinks, but we had no idea. hang on a minute. Hello, Indonesia. Hello, Indonesia. I want to say hello to Indonesia because my family is from Indonesia. Mm-hmm. So there's Fiaza. Hi, I recognize her logo.
Oh, cool.
But yeah, my family's from Indonesia from the early 20s. And then we came over to Holland in the... we had to leave Indonesia because of the war and stuff in like the 48, I believe, 51, 52, that kind of thing. Tell the cameraman not to touch the camera. I know. Sorry, guys. I'm doing my best. So.
Okay, I missed the question that went up about the carrot. Here we are. From Chris. Back to my carrots here in Central Valley. I was so inspired by my carrot video and built a cool planet box specifically for this project. I wonder if I plan too soon in the summer. Well, yeah, carrots do like the cool weather. They don't like the heat. Mine aren't really getting carrots yet. It's just not getting cool. So I expect the carrots to be growing soon. But yeah, once the weather cools off, you're going to see some carrots. My lettuce is not growing in my pot. So hopefully, Chris, that helps. My lettuce is not growing in my pots. Is it too cool at night? That's from DigiShots Photography. What climate do you live in? Like, how cool is it right now? Where are you at, DigiShot? So maybe that can help. Can you update on the composter? You mean the compost pile, Michael? Hopefully we'll do some new composting videos after the first of the year, 2017, maybe in January, February. Hello from Khalid. Thanks so much, Chris. Hopefully that helped. OBS for live streaming from Brad.
Okay. I'm going to write that down.
How is your grapevine doing? I haven't seen an update on that.
Thanks, Brad.
Aaliyah, that's a great question. My grapevine, actually, I haven't done a lot with it. I just haven't had time. It's probably about time for me to prune it, so hopefully I'll be doing that and pruning it back. And I'm still learning about grape growing. I'm not an expert at it. When do you recommend starting summer seeds in general, Zone 7?
Well, I think we're
Zone
okay.
7, Allison, where is that located? I'm not exactly sure where Zone 7 is, but I'll be starting my summer seeds probably January, February.
It looks like we are.
And Michael asked, do you still have the watermelon plant?
Like,
I actually took it out this afternoon.
We're gonna send an email to
I figured it was getting too cold, and I wanted to get some broccoli and cauliflower and Brussels sprouts planted in that planter. So I just pulled it out. I figured I was not going to get any more melon from it anyway.
Yeah, that's weird.
Have you ever lived in a cold climate? Asking for compost advice. They're from Butch Bundle. Butch, I have. I actually grew up in Colorado, but I never built a compost pile in Colorado, so I'm not real familiar with how to do it in a cold climate. But from what I understand, you can just kind of pile it up and let it freeze over the winter time, and then once it gets warm in the springtime, things will start to melt, and your compost will start cooking again. Okay, Aaliyah, thanks for doing this. Thank you, Aaliyah. I start my season January in Zone 9 from Marina. Yep, that's what I do too. Aw, Mac, will appreciate your ear rub, Keela. Keith asks, do you guys water your strawberries over the dormant season? I'm in New Jersey and have them in the garage. Okay, I do water my strawberries over the winter time. My strawberries don't really go dormant because our weather is warm all winter. If your strawberries are going dormant, you do want to keep them moist, but definitely keep them cold enough, like a garage is perfect, so they don't come out of dormancy and then you have some trouble with them. So hopefully that helps. So David, you're planting tomatoes in zone 10B. Wow, lucky you. Hopefully you can keep them going over the wintertime. Michael, thank you so much. He says, Kim, you're the reason I started gardening. Thank you for inspiring me. Thank you. That really means a lot to me. I mean, that's really why I do it, is to share my love of gardening with other people. So I'm really glad that that's helped you. Faiza says, I loved your winter harvest video. The radishes look great. Yeah, the radishes are actually one of my favorite vegetables so far. They just add such a great zip to salads, and they're so bright and colorful. I really like how they taste. And you've been having them on your salads at work too, the radishes?
Yes.
Yeah, those are really yummy. Mm-hmm. What were you telling me?
That's the camera right there.
Okay, so I know. I'm trying to read the comments.
Okay, I'm just letting you know. We're just sure if you knew.
Yeah. Thank you so much for everyone who's saying how much I've inspired you. That really does mean a lot to me, so I'm really glad to hear that. Really just helps give me motivation too, just to keep on doing what we're doing. So thanks a lot. What tomatoes do you recommend for the tropics? That's a good question. I mean, I have my favorite varieties, like Kellogg's Breakfast. Oh, there's Hardcore Gardener. Hi. Hi, Rich. How you doing? That's so cool.
That is way cool. Gosh.
I haven't grown in the tropics, but we're in the subtropics, basically. So, like, Kellogg's Breakfast is my favorite. Bloody Butcher always does really well for me. Go back through some of my tomato videos and you could take a look at some of my favorite tomatoes. Let's see. Pam asks, I started my outdoor plants the same time, but I did, but they are so small. Is it because they need more sun each day? Pam, I'm not too sure what you mean. Do you mean like your fall vegetables, your cool weather vegetables? I'm not sure. Let's see what else. I'm in zone 9. My garlic is doing great because of you. I went back and binge watched all your videos. That's from Keela. Wow, thanks, Keela. The garlic is really cool here in zone 9 because it sprouts up in the wintertime, and I just think it's so pretty, these little garlic shoots coming up through the soil. And I have mine, like you saw in the garlic video, in that purple smart pots, and it just looks really, really pretty. So yeah, if you're in a warm winter climate, you're going to see growth from your garlic all winter long, which is really fun. But definitely don't harvest it for a while. You want it to grow those nice garlic bulbs, unless you just want to clip off the shoots to throw in like a recipe or something. So, okay, cool weather vegetables. Pam, depending on what climate you're in, Pam, if you're in a warm winter climate like I am here in SoCal, then your cool weather veggies will start to take off now because it's finally getting cool and we're getting some rain. The nights are getting cool. So that might be the problem if it's possibly too hot. So, oh, yours are huge and mine are tiny. Okay, are you, Pam, do you live in Southern California or somewhere where it's warm in the wintertime? Because, you know, I did keep mine shaded, and that really helped in the hot weather. So, you know, hopefully yours will take off, you know, if you live in a warm winter climate. If you use the garlic greens and use some of them, it will stop the garlic bulb growth. Yes, definitely. Thanks for bringing that up. If you cut off the garlic shoots, then your bulbs won't get as big. So what I like to do is keep a couple garlic shoots going, or garlic going just for the shoots, and then save most of it, you know, so it'll grow the nice garlic bulbs. Hi, Luke. How you doing? Good to see Emma Gardner on here, too. And let's see. Oh, Acton. Pam's in Acton. Okay, Pam. So definitely, yeah, now that it's getting cooler, your cooler plants should definitely take off. So hopefully that will help. Why would you recommend growing plants? You mean, Victor, do you mean like just growing a garden? Or I'm not too sure what your question is. Hello from Mexico City, Narelle Winburn. Hi, Narelle. And Firza says, I actually started to grow my veggie here in Indonesia because of your harvesting videos. Need to watch them over and over again whenever I get frustrated by weeds. Yeah, weeds are kind of frustrating. But I'm really glad that you're growing, and don't let those weeds stop you, because you can just pull them out and, you know, you get those great vegetables growing through the weeds too. And hopefully if you stay on top of them, then you can get a lot of great veggies. Luke asks, gay live stream. I know this is really totally unplanned, but what's your favorite type of lettuce to grow? I absolutely love the black-seeded Simpson. It really seems to be very heat tolerant here in Southern Cal. And I just harvested a whole bunch last weekend, which actually made it through 90 degree temperatures for a good solid 3 months. Held up pretty well. And even though most of it had bolted, it still tasted very, very flavorful. It wasn't too bitter. And we ate it all week long. So it's been great. Zone 9 lettuce seems not to be doing anything. Okay, well, I'm in Zone 9B, so you're probably real close to me, CJ. And give it some time. Just hang in there. Be patient. It's just getting cool here. So I think it's really going to take off. Wow, did not expect this to pop up. We actually didn't either, Dark Faith. We were not planning on live streaming. We were just testing it out. And here we are online. So Australia, we have more people from Australia. Well, this is really exciting. With all the gardening videos now on YouTube, who do you follow? That's a great question, David. I always watch Luke's videos, Gary Pilarchuk, Garden Answer. Those are some of my favorite gardeners. I think those are probably the main ones that I watch. I also watch California Gardening, or Gardener, I think he is. He's here near me. So, okay, let's see. Have you ever grown figs? I don't recall seeing in your garden. That's from M.I. Gardener. No, I have not. I've never grown figs. It would be cool to try, though. I haven't grown a lot of fruit trees, or just kind of running out of space. Nobody. And I just never seem to have good luck with fruit trees. So.
Yeah, we don't do well with the fruit trees.
I think it's maybe because I'm so busy with the other parts of the garden that they kind of get neglected. And, you know, if I put some time into it, I could probably do a lot better of a job at it. But, yeah, figs would be a lot of fun to try.
Oh, this is funny.
Let's see. What's your favorite watermelon to grow? My favorite watermelon to grow is definitely the Orange Glow. So I'm hoping to get some bigger watermelon next summer. My watermelon didn't do too well this year. M.I. Gardener, Luke, yes, I do need to grow figs. Hopefully, I know nothing about growing figs, so maybe I'll have to watch some of your videos and figure out how to grow them. Because I do really like figs. What's your favorite thing to grow and why, from Charlene? Let's see, favorite thing to grow. I mean, I love growing tomatoes. Those, to me, are like the queen of the garden. So that's a lot of fun. There's so many different varieties and colors. But peppers I love, too, because it's fun to... I mean, I have a really hard time picking my peppers. I know that's crazy, but the colors are just so beautiful, and I love to see them out there. It's like flowers to me. So usually by the time I pick them, they're starting to get a little bit wrinkled because I leave them on a little bit too long, but I just throw them in the freezer and make like pepper jelly out of them or something, so... Do you have any favorite garden stores, from Allison Kramer? Probably not. I really order a lot of my stuff online. Most of my seeds I get from Luke. And I wouldn't say I really have any favorite garden stores. I mean, I'm at Home Depot usually every couple of weeks, but I don't really call that particularly a garden store. But anyway, what was the first thing that you planted, from Argentina, from Manuel? The first thing I ever planted was my very first garden on my own in our house here was probably tomatoes. So peppers, yep, hardcore gardener, Rich, I know you love peppers too. So yeah, they're great. There's so many different varieties and colors. It's a lot of fun. Do you, oh, you still have a small screen. How do you grow onions in the winter? From Corey Duval. Well, I just kind of leave some planted usually from the summertime, and they pretty much grow for me all winter long because, again, we don't really get freezes here. We get very light frosts, so I can pretty much leave them in year-round. I just have a few in my garden right now, but I'm actually going to be starting some onion seeds pretty soon, so I'll probably be able to get them planted, you know, in a couple of months. I'll start them indoors and grow them and then stick them outside. Okay, let's see. I think I've seen that knife guy before. Oh, Justin, talking about Joey's channel.
Yeah, yeah, Joey Adelino. He changed his channel name to Joey Adelino, but you'll still find him. Yeah, it's incredible what he does.
Yeah, right. It is incredible. He's got a really cool channel. It's going to be winter soon. What is the best herb to grow indoors? From Ravi. Let's see. I think, personally, I feel like basil is pretty easy to grow. If you still have some growing outside, you can just take some cuttings, put it in water, it'll root. And then you can put it in soil or just keep it in water and it'll root on your windowsill. Just change the water like every day or every other day just to kind of keep it going. But I am going to be doing some indoor growing, so make sure you stay tuned for that. Hopefully we'll get the first video posted on that this week. But just a little FYI, and my gardener just put together a microgreens and sprouting kit on his website specifically for my indoor growing series. So make sure you hop on over there, get that kit so you'll be ready to grow with me. I'm going to be doing microgreens, sprouting. I'm going to try a tomato indoors and a cucumber indoors. I've never done that before, so we'll see how that goes. But if you head over to amigardener.com, I think it's /CaliKim29. I'm going to grab my phone. I can grab the affiliate code, but you can get a 10% discount on seeds at his seed store. So thank you very much, Luke, for providing that. And when you purchase seeds through my code, then it helps me out as well. So, but that way you can get going with the microgreens as well. So let me just make sure I have the code correct.
So while she looks that up, is this pretty cool, you guys? Do you think this is something that you would like to do regularly? We don't know how often yet. But is it something that you would like to do regularly, maybe Q&A kind of time? And we want to keep it light. We don't want to get into controversial subjects and pick sides and things like that. But just, you know, have fun, get to know each other, and just put some faces and personalities and stuff together. So anyhow, this has been really fun. Okay, cool, Chris. Thanks. Total by accident again. Next thing we knew, we were like broadcasting. And we just thought we were able to test this. And basically, I fired up the software, I guess, and we started getting people streaming and stuff. So, are you ready?
Yeah, I did find that that code. Cool. It's migardener.com/CaliKim29. So you just want to go over to his website, put in that code, and you can go to his store and pretty much purchase anything over there for 10% off. So, but definitely check out the microgreens and sprouting kit. And I'm also going to be giving his cherry Chadwick tomato. That's the one I'm going to be trying to grow indoors.
Hi, so Mumbai Balcony Gardener.
Oh, cool. She's on. All right. Awesome. This is so much fun.
This is way fun.
Hardcore Gardener Likes This Life format. This is very cool. Yeah, I really like it too. Glad you and my gardener do things. Yes, it's great. Luke and I really love working together. It's been a lot of fun to get to know him and Cindy. And he's been great to work with. Really just been awesome on his website to put together some great seed packages for us. And by the way, make sure you check out the $10 garden kit is restocked, and I believe the fall garden kit as well. So he's restocked everything. If you haven't checked out his seed store, he's really got some great new varieties. So head on over there to check it out. Okay, let's see. I love your harvesting videos. Great. Thank you so much. It's really a lot of fun. It was fun to have. Did you guys like
having Justin.
A camera guy on there last week? It was fun to...
You're not my nephew, Justin, are you, Justin? I wonder if it is.
Could be. Sorry. Who knows? But anyway, he hasn't been on quite as much just because he's been doing some pretty heavy-duty projects at work, but we're hoping to get him on more, and maybe with a live stream, that'd be fun too. Mm-hmm. Okay, let's see. What are you most excited about for your winter garden? From Justin. I am actually excited now that it's finally getting cool outside. I mean, we have had 90-degree temperatures September, October, November. And I'm really excited that we're getting rain, and hopefully some of my cool weather stuff like my broccoli and Brussels sprouts and cauliflower will actually start growing now. So this is cool. Okay.
Read the code again. That's very nice of the Grime Fighters.
Oh, okay. Thank you very much, the Grime Fighters.
Excuse me.
Appreciate your support with on migardner.com. The code is migardner.com/CaliKim29. So if you type that in over there at his website, then you'll get the discount, and then it'll help me out as well. So
thank you so Grime
much.
Fighters.
Okay, besides chasing mice, how do you deal with bugs and snails from CJ? Well, we do have a rat problem in my garden. So we put out rat traps for the mouse. Bugs and snails, I do have some snails and slugs actually in my strawberries. And if you go back and watch one of my strawberry tip videos, I actually like to prop them up on forks. Tracy Monster is a viewer and also has a YouTube channel. She gave me that little tip, and that keeps the slugs off the strawberries. So as far as aphids and other bugs in the garden, I usually like to wash them off as much as I can just with a stream of water first. And then kind of my go-to, if that doesn't work, is neem oil. And you can get neem oil over on Gary Pillarchuk's website, The Rusted Garden. So check that out, and his neem oil works really, really well. Okay, cool. Oh, cool. Thank you, Jerry, for putting that in.
Yeah, Susan said, hey, put the link in the chat.
Oh, thanks.
Oh, yeah, I forgot we could do that.
Cool. Is there any, let's see, questions I'm seeing here. Whitefly or caterpillar with some hair that itch if touched? That I don't know. I don't know. I'm sure there's some caterpillars out there that might make you itch, or I'm not sure about that for sure, but... Michael, thank you so much for saying you love my videos. Really appreciate that. Thank you so much for your support. And, thank you, Wisconsin Vegetable Gardener.
We remember the beer thing.
Yes, thank you for reminding me about that.
Did we ever do that?
We did, actually.
We did. In the very back in the day, I think we tried the beer thing. It was pretty funny.
The beer traps are really good for killing slugs. And what you can do is, what I've done before, you cut a water bottle in half, or you just cut the bottom, use the little bottom piece of the water bottle, and put a little bit of beer in there, if you don't mind putting some of your beer out in the garden so they're drinking it. And then it attracts the slugs and the snails. They'll fall in there, and then they eat it, and then they die. So thank you so much, Holly and Joey, from Wisconsin Vegetable Gardener, for bringing that up.
I'm going to interrupt here and tell you guys a funny story. Mikkel said, why aren't you on TV? And there's a funny story behind this, because Kim did get an email that said, hi, you know, we're a production company. We're going to do this garden improvement show. And would you be interested in auditioning, you know, to be the host? And I said, and I called Kim. I go, you got to call these people. You know, it's Hollywood. It's New York. You got to move fast. You got to tell them, yeah, you know, I'd be interested. And so she had already sent an email back and said, well, let me think about it for a week or so, and I'll get back to you. And I remember just going, what did you say to them? You told them you're going to get back to them? Well, in the industry, you know, once you say that, you're off the list. You're not going to get a call back. So kind of a funny story. And while it's not our goal for a TV show kind of a thing, I mean, that's not why we're doing this. Personally, I wouldn't mind. I think it'd be kind of fun. But I don't really know that.
Well, what I told Jerry is that I just want to be in the garden. I just want to be in the garden. I don't want to be on TV, but who knows? We'll see if anything ever happens.
You never know. Anyway, funny that you brought that up. So thanks for letting me tell that story.
So Kath Punk mentioned that balls of hair will help keep the bugs from climbing up your plant. So I've never tried that before. So thank you so much for the tip on that. And one thing too I wanted to say is it's really fun to learn from each other. I mean,
totally.
I don't know everything about gardening, so I really enjoy just seeing all the comments and how people are jumping in, sharing with each other. I mean, it's really great to have a garden community where people can just throw tips out there and learn from each other. So I love it. CJ, do they die happy when the slugs drink the beer?
Of course they do.
Yeah, I'm sure they do. They're probably really happy, so don't feel too bad about killing
them. That's
funny. How about growing celery in South Florida from Mari Mari? You know what? Celery, it's crazy. I actually rooted a celery from the store probably 3 years ago. So, and that is the only time I have ever planted celery, but it goes to seed, and then the seeds just drop all over the place, and I have celery all over the place now. So give it a try. I think you could do it. If I can do it in Southern California, but you could do it in South Florida. So dark faith, if you feel like celery is hard, that worked perfectly for me. And all I did was I just used the base of the celery. So in other words, just cut the stalks of the celery off. I put it in water for a couple of days, just a cup of water on my windowsill. And I believe I think I cut the bottom off too. And the roots started to grow out the bottom, and then it kind of sprouted off the top, and then just threw it in the ground. So that was about 3 years ago, and I've never planted it again, and I have celery every single year. So let's see. And my gardener, you know you're on TV. Just turn on Chromecast and I see you there. Is that like your smart TV, Luke? Probably, huh?
Yeah, Luke,
that's bizarre.
Luke, you need to come over and revamp all of our technology. I am so out of touch, and I've heard of Chromecast. I just don't know what it is, and you know, I'm at the age where I'm like, ooh, stay away from that. You know, it's going to break your device.
No, he's a techie guy. Don't
Luke
let
totally
him.
Is, I think.
No, I mean, Jerry is too.
I think we need to get Luke out here.
Have you thought of aquaponics or honeybees? Chris Dowling, sorry. I have thought of honeybees, but I just haven't had the time to do it, and I'm not sure how it works, like with my neighbors and all that kind of stuff. So, yeah, I'm not so sure if that's something that I'll get into. Aquaponics would be kind of fun to try, like maybe a small setup of some kind. I'm probably not something I would get full into, but it would be kind of fun to try a small setup. What did Tara say there?
Oops.
Tara, I've done that in the house by cutting off the bottom, but never put it in the ground. With a celery, Tara? Yeah. Yeah, it grows super easy on the windowsill, and then throw it in the ground and see what happens. Okay, cool.
Hmm.
Oh, thank you, Michael. He said my show would be a hit on TV.
Oh, that's nice.
Thank you. Hi from Iowa, Cord Oliver. Hi, Cord. CJ saying we had to pick some bugs and snails. I tried to remove it. A gross large tomato worm, and it literally turned towards me and split out green liquid out of me. Intelligent worm. Was that maybe it was like a hand worm or a hornworm, tomato hornworm? I'm not sure. But
hey, did anyone else's screen freeze? Because ours did on our other laptop that we're watching, like we were a viewer. So if you can type something, I don't know if we're still moving or not. Anyway, keep going. Apparently people can still hear us.
Okay, good. Wow, this is just, I can't believe all the comments that are coming in. I'm just like floored. I had no idea this many people would be like online. This is crazy.
Yeah, neither did we.
Thank you so much for all your teaching. Now I have a green thumb. That's awesome. Keep posting videos. I'm so glad to hear that because I really feel like absolutely anybody can grow their own food. Especially if you start small with, you know, something like lettuce or whatever. But I feel like anyone can do it. So whenever people tell me they have a black thumb, I don't believe them. I just feel like maybe they haven't tried, you know, to start easy enough or simple enough. So I'm really, really glad to hear that, Ravi. So let's see what else.
Yeah, typo.
Yeah, I guess so. Okay. Well,
oh gosh,
do we have any other questions? 44 people is nothing. Well, I don't know how many people are on, but this is just really, really cool.
I think that number down in the corner means that
many
people are on, and I'm afraid to touch anything on the iPad because it's gonna, you know, do something. So anyway, I don't know what that I does.
Oh, 47.
But someone suggested I look into a software called YouNow Live. YouNow. So I'm gonna look at that software. I'm not too sure how wild I am about this software that we're using here. I forgot what it's called. But, yeah, I don't know how wild I am about it. Oh,
so
gosh.
Tara is asking about when we're starting the microgreens. Is that what you're talking about, Tara? I'm thinking so. You just ordered the seeds. I'm thinking this week we should be able to get the video shot and posted later in the week. So I actually have some going right behind me here. Let me see if I can get a little preview shot of this. These are, if you guys can see these or not, but I started some a couple weeks ago. This one I think I started 11/16, so maybe a week ago. These are little pea shoots. These are Lincoln peas. So it's going to be a lot of fun. I'm just growing these on my windowsill, not using any sun or anything like that, or any like lights, you know, indoor grow lights or anything like that. So it's super easy. Microgreens are so healthy and so like nutrient dense, and it's something you can grow super easy in the wintertime. So really excited about that. I think you guys will have a lot of fun doing it. So Cool. Callie Kim, I know she rarely wears garden gloves. Doesn't camera guy like smooth hands? Wallace. We're live streaming.
Wallace.
An accident, you guys.
They're smooth.
You know, I just don't like wearing garden gloves that much, except when I'm holding my tools, so. So Michael's asking about a book that's 1,000 pages long. Well,
now he's saying, can you write a book?
Yeah, can I write a book that's 1,000 pages long? Well, we'll see. There's some stuff in the works, so I don't want to let too much out of the bag, but
yeah.
Stay tuned for more info. So.
Oh, thanks, Tara.
Yeah, Tara, I'm excited too. I can't wait to get the indoor growing series started. It'll be a lot of fun. Susan's saying a lot of people live stream YouTube and Facebook at the same time.
Oh, this just got complicated.
Yeah. I know Luke did that on his launch, so we might on his seed store launch, so we might have to get some pointers from Luke. I think he had two different computers going, one with Facebook Live and one with...
We'll check it out.
Yeah. So, let's see. I heart Frigga says, my beans froze and my garden is dying. The temp got into the 20s last night, and we're looking at snow for the next 2 days. I have no space in my house that gets good sun. Well, you could... Like, the microgreens I'm growing are on my windowsill. It gets no direct sun. So, it actually... could work really well for you. And there's also a way that you can get a super easy grow light set up indoors. I have a little grow light box actually right behind me here, and I have a video on that.
Yep.
That you could check out.
There's a grow light box right down there.
Right down here. So anyway, it's actually really, really easy. It's just a little plastic bin. You know, should I hold it up? It's a little plastic bin that you get at Target.
Ugh.
All right, you guys, I'll hold this up.
Here it comes.
Okay, see this right here? This is my grow light box. I always have this going inside. So go back and check out the grow light box video, and you can get one going inside your house too. And you can grow like a little tray of lettuce or something like that indoors, just so you have some fresh salads in the winter time, which is always really nice. Okay, let's see here. What to do with my strawberries with the winter coming in NorCal, from Thomas. Thomas, I am not an expert in because I don't really have to do that here. Just to give them a little bit of the mountains, you might. If your strawberries are in ground, you can just throw some straw in there to help protect them. But strawberries are actually very cold hardy, usually down to about 10 degrees. So if anyone else, you know, grows strawberries in the, you know, cold winter areas, you can probably give a little bit more advice for that than I can. But okay. Mm.
That just
What's
turned,
that?
I don't know, someone says we're froze again.
Oh, okay. Frozen again. No, I will not be growing any recreational marijuana. Let's see.
That's so funny, though, I want to talk about that. Someone at my work, they were like, you know, the California, the whole marijuana thing was on the ballot, and they came up to me and they said, hey, do you got a minute? I'm like, yeah, what's going on? He goes, well, your wife gardens, right? I go, yeah. And he's like, do you think she'd be interested in going into business with me? And I said, no, we're a gardening channel. We're, you know, we're food you eat. We're not about that.
We're growing veggies.
So keeping it simple. Don't make this confusing, or, you know, I'm not trying to start a controversial subject here. I just thought it was just really funny. He was like, hey, would your wife be interested? She's a good gardener. And I'm like, it's just kind of funny. So
anyway, well, do you want to keep?
Well,
you guys, we are going to do this again. This was totally impromptu, and it was actually really fun.
This is really fun for a total accident.
I know, a total accident, but we definitely will be doing it again. And it's just, I think it's a great way to connect with everyone and just answer some questions and everything. Oh, here's a great answer from Joey and Holly from Wisconsin Vegetable Garden about strawberries. So
those guys know their stuff,
yeah,
too.
Yeah, so go over and check out their channel as well. And what they're saying is in Wisconsin, in zone 5A, they've never covered our strawberries, and they produce well each year, and our temps get down to 0 degrees and below. So that's great information. Great information. So thank you so much, Joey and Holly, for sharing that. let's see. DW Marshall. Oh, cool. The live feed. It's an early Christmas present. Oh, thank you.
This is going to make me cry. People are being so nice.
It's so nice.
I was not expecting that or
Can
anything.
You do this tomorrow by the garden?
Actually, that was our plan. Our plan was to try it tomorrow, you know, do a little broadcast on Instagram, you know, hey, we're going to go live and we're going to do it down by the garden. And then I accidentally hit the button and next thing we knew, we were streaming. So I looked at Kim, I go, I think we're streaming. And Kim goes, yeah, I think we're live right now. So that's kind of funny. That's funny. So do we want to do it tomorrow still?
Sure,
then?
Yeah.
But it's supposed to rain.
No, in the afternoon.
Okay.
So if you guys, you know, if you guys would like this, or if you guys like this, we can head down to the garden tomorrow and maybe just kind of show you around a little bit.
Okay, so what time, California time, should we say? We should commit.
We should commit to a time? What if we want to sleep in?
I'm talking like 10 o'clock or 11 o'clock PST.
Okay, maybe
right?
10 o'clock.
All right.
10 o'clock-ish. Okay.
Yeah. Barring technical difficulties. All right, so 10 a.m. 10 a.m. California time, and we'll go for it again, and we'll just see how it works down there. Who knows?
Yeah, we'll give it a try.
You know, all right, we are going to do it. But, yeah, we're going to try it with one of those little hotspot things, you know, from your cell phone company and see if we can get a good connection down there.
Just bring the iPad down, I guess, huh?
Yeah.
Cool.
We'll bring the iPad down.
So 10-ish a.m. Pacific time.
Yep. I'll write that in the chat right now.
So we'll try and stick as close as we can to 10. So that'll be cool.
10 a.m.
A couple people asked about the sprouting and microgreens. You really don't need anything particular. I guess for the microgreens, I'm just going to be using some basic containers I can find around my house. Nothing special, whatever happens to fit in my windowsill. This here that I have my little pea shoots in is just a little, like a meat tray or something. You get meat in from the grocery store. And for sprouting, I'll just be using a mason jar. I do have a sprouting lid, but you can just use like a tea towel or a coffee filter. So, you know, we keep it quick, simple, inexpensive here, so it's nothing too rocket science that you're going to need. So, okay, guys, I think we're going to sign off here.
Hey, Chevy. I had to say that.
Tune in again tomorrow, hopefully we'll get to see you guys again down by the garden, okay? It's been a lot of fun. Thank you so much for tuning in.
Yeah, now how do we turn it off?
Bye, guys. I'm not sure.
I don't know how to turn this off. Maybe everyone's just going to have coffee and a glass of wine with us. Oh, there it is.
Yeah,
what did you do? How did you do that?
Getting ready to have some wine.
Okay.
Thanks, Tara.
Bye,
see you later.
Guys. I think we hit that red square. Here we go in 3, 2, 1.
Bye-bye.
Chevy, later.